Hey guys, today I want to try something new. Today I want to show you how I'd go about modeling a little low-poly tugboat using Blender. I'm going to try to do it as smoothly as possible, but I'm expecting mistakes to be made along the way. So first, I'll delete everything in the scene, except for my little cube, and drag him up. I'm holding control so that he snaps to the Z-axis, and I want to keep the two planes on the sides. I'm going to get rid of everything else, so I'm going to hit the number 3 to select faces only, select these, and press X, and D to delete them. Whoops. X and F to delete the faces. I'm actually going to delete this one too. Not sure why my cube moved, but yeah, I'm just going to delete that and end up with just a plane. Grab my line down at the bottom and I'm going to shift it so that it's right on the y-axis. Now I'm going to go into my modifiers panel and turn on my mirror along the along the x-axis. That looks good, I guess. So I'm going to press the 1 on the keypad to look at it from the side, press the number 1 in my keyboard, and Z in wireframe. And I want to make this centered here too. I don't know how this moved. Alright. Let's make this a little bigger. Hit G and then Y. Sure, that looks good. So we got a little boat shape here. We can move that out, pressing G and then X. That looks good. And I'm also gonna mirror on the Y. Alright, so we got our basic hull here. So, Control R, subdivide it a few times. Turn on clipping and grab this point and drag it along the y-axis or the x-axis and do the same for this one to have them converge. Now they're locked since we turned on clipping. Grab this point and this one and right-click, merge vertices at last. And now we got a little basic boat shape. I'm going to turn on proportional editing, look at it from the top, and let's give it a little shape. I'm just selecting these, and then hitting G, and you can use the mouse wheel to select how much of an area you want it to affect. So I think that looks pretty good. Yeah, that'll do for a little boat. Let's widen it up in the middle a little bit too. I think we want to move only on the x-axis. And let's make this a little smaller. Let's look at it from the top too, so we can see what we're doing. To change the different view modes or render modes. There you go. I'm just eyeballing this stuff. I'm gonna shut off proportional editing. I think we got a basic little boat shape here. So next, I am going to, maybe I'll thicken it. So I'm going to our modifiers. Let's just apply this just to keep things simple. And the solidify. Let's see what looks good here. Go for a nice low poly boat, so I want this to be nice and thick. I like even thicknesses. And that's good enough. Let's apply that too. Alright, boat's getting there. Now for a little tugboat, we want it to have a little cutout so people can walk down the side and take a nice look. So let's make a shape to cut out of this. I think I'll do that with a cube. Again, just keeping everything nice and simple. Now move it up. Tab to go into edit. Scale it on the Y. Up a little higher. Just remove that whole upper rim. Now Control R. Two splits. I'm gonna hit Z and go into wireframe. Select all my lower points. You know what? Let's subdivide one more time. Give it a little bit of a slope. So I'm gonna hit S to scale. And Control R axes. Press Y. I want to go up this far. I'm gonna scale again. And now only on Z. Up that far. We'll see how we're looking. Take it all with A, scale only on the x-axis. Alright. Oops. Tab, there you go. So I'm going to select my boat, go into my modifiers, find the boolean, click the eyedropper. This is selecting the object that it's going to use as a tool to remove from the main object. So now if I hide the cube we just added, we get our cool little boat shape here. I can even right click on it and shade it smooth. And to get rid of things like this here, you click on this little triangle here that's for, I don't even know. But you can go into normals and auto smooth. And it does clean it up a bit. It does show more lines, but it does give you a cleaner look. But alright, we got our main shape. I'm gonna go back into my modifiers and just apply it. That way I have all of my geometry visible here. I can manipulate it freely. I'm gonna need it. Because I am hitting the number 2 to switch over to just lines. Holding Alt and clicking here to select the entire loop. And hitting F to create a face. Now, I am hitting G and Z. Oh, nope. Control D and Z. Move it up. Click on that face. Select faces. Click on the face and hit delete to get rid of it. Faces. Select the face and bring it back down. Hit Z to control the axes. I'm going to go a little bit further up and scale it until it's going through all of it. We'll go around for areas where it's sticking out. We're sticking out on the side, so I'm going to look at it from the top. Scale again. Hit Y, so I'm only scaling that axis. Or that axis. Bring it in. Last check. Are we breaking through anywhere? A little bit here. I think we just need to go a little bit further. S, Y, just touch. There you go. Not breaking through. Just one clean plane for the whole boat. No one will ever see that. Alright, so now we need somewhere for our crew to sit. So let's get out of here. Leave this as just the hull. Since we applied it, we can just delete this piece. And let's that's not what it is, let me know in the comments. I think that's all. Alright, so let's add a cube. Center this thing. I'm going to look at it from the side. Hit tab to edit it. Bring it up. Only on the Z. That's probably good. I want it to break through the floor a little, but not much. I'm holding control. And if it snaps too far, just hit shift. And that gives you a bit more control. Alright. So I'm just going to eyeball the rest of this. I want my boat to be looking towards the left, so I'm going to drag my little box over to the right. Hit G and Y and just drag it over until it looks good. I'm going to scale it on the X axis only. And I think we have our main little base here. So I'm going to hit Control R and drag this up. 3, Alt and click. And I'm going to hit E to extrude it. I don't want to go anywhere, so I'm just going to hit Escape. And now we can scale it in. Now, since we don't want it to look like this hourglass shape, hit Shift and Z. And that tells it not to scale on the Z axis. And just bring it in somewhere that it looks good. That's been nice. Get our little top, and I'm going to eye to inset it. My mouse is too close to the middle. I'm just going to move it away from it and hit eye again. There you go. And E to go down. Alright, probably need a nice little window. Probably around that height. And I'm just going to put it there and there. There we go, nice little window that I could add to both sides. Let's put it down the middle too. Alright, so in the 3D select faces. I'm gonna get rid of half of it. 1 to select points. I want all the points on this side and delete them. That didn't work. Try it again. X and V for vertices. Alright. Did that because I want a mirror modifier. That way we only have to do things once. Mirror. Alright, select 3 for faces. E to extrude. I to inset. E to intrude. Or extrude, intrude. It's intruding. Alright, we got a little window. I like it. That's good enough for there, I think. For here, I don't know why it's being weird, but I'm just going to pretend it's not. That looks pretty good for a door. Select 3 for faces. 1, 2, 3. Hit I. And now, to get rid of this, I'm just going to delete these. Whoa! Clipping. Delete faces. There you go. 2 to select edges. And then G, Y, X. There you go. Now, E, extrude. And E to go all the way in. That's good. That looks good. Do the same here. I bring it in a little bit, select these, X, F, 2, both lines, G, Y, X, and then faces. E. Nice, cool little front window. Alright, what else does our little tugboat need? Nice little railing. What's up with the floor on this? Whoops. Oh, gee. See, and let's just go up one. We don't need any of this. I don't know why it's being weird. Whoa. Not the best, but it's fixed. R, G, Z, negative one. Go back home. Alright. So, tab. Now I think we need a railing. So, how to make a railing? Let's start with a plane. C. Tab, edit. G, that way. I think I'm just gonna delete three of the points to have one. Bring that down to the middle. Bring it up to the front. Yeah, that looks about right. And let's make that zero. Let's just go from here, and I'm going to hit E to extrude, Z to lock it on the Z, and then E again, want to only go on the Y, go to about here, E to go down and kind of match it, E again, hit Y, then E, E, and Y. Now, I'm gonna add a point for each one of these places since that's probably the curvature we're gonna need. So there, and then just G to move it, hit Y to lock it on that, do it again. Space these out as evenly as we can. Just hitting Control R to add or to split these and just adding a point wherever it looks like it could need one. Alright. Now E and Z. Now it looks like 1.7. Down to where it looks good. probably have too many of these, but it's probably not solo poly anymore. Alright, so let's add a skin modifier. Yeah, and now, forget, I think up here we could turn on X-ray and select all and just control A, just bring the mouse in. Look at that. And symmetry on nowhere. Smooth shading. That looks good. Be a little thinner. Oops, control A. There you go. Shut off X-ray. Alright, we got a little railing. And let's undo. No. Alright, add modifier, skin. This button, X-ray, control A, make it thinner, smooth shading, this button, oops, have to hit alt, tab, can't apply modifier when you're in it. Cool, alright, I don't want X-ray anymore, bothers me. And we got one side, so let's just mirror. Huh. Look at that. Nice. Alright, what else does any tugboat need? Tires on the side. Wait a minute, what's this? Disgusting. G. X. Brand new. Oh. GX. 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 I don't see them. They're gone. Good. Whoa. That's a lot of polygons. I didn't see it. Alright. What's this need? Tires. Let's just add a sphere. Let's keep it simple. Let's make this 8. Nah, 16. Already went crazy with the railing. 90. That's good enough. Scale it. Move it. Top view. Move it. Side view. Scale it. Top view, scale it on the X. Got a tire. Now, 3, that face, I, make it smaller, X, F, 2, Alt click, Shift, Alt click, right click, bridge edge, loops, there you go. Get a tire. Now, 2, Alt click, Shift Alt click, Control B, pull, and mouse wheel up to add one more little ridge, really sell it. And click off of it, now click, oops, Alt click, and Shift Alt click, Control B, and get rid of it for a nice inner room. Right click on it, shade smooth, get a tire. And I think it needs to be a little beefier. I don't remember how to make it beefier. Oh yeah. Wireframe. Just the lines. Alt click, shift alt click, just to select all of these, because I'm going to pull them in. Scale, and just, oh yeah, and shift X so we're not making it too narrow. There you go, just as thick, but brought on the board. I think that's good. Yep, time to bring them in. GX. That looks good. Lining up the green and red lines with the horizontal and vertical center lines, and that looks pretty good. Yep. Okay. Bring everything back. Just tab out of that, and now we can move it easily. I think. Click on it, and just hit G, rotate. G. Yeah, it looks a little too rotated. They normally hang off, so that should probably be pretty straight anyways. Let's just make it a little smaller. Alright. So now shift D. Where is our railing? Rotate this one. Looks funny. There you go. Nice little tugboat. Railing is here? Yeah. All of them. Control J. Now they're just one. Called tire. And let's mirror them on the Y. Y. Object, apply, all transforms. Now let's do it. Yeah. Alright. I don't think I'm gonna get into coloring this thing at all, but cool. We got a little tugboat. We can just float around and push things and pull things. Wait, don't tugboats have a little stack? Yeah. Yeah, the stack goes in the front. Alright, can't have a tugboat that's missing a stack. So, quickly, let's add a mesh cylinder. Just bring it right up. I don't care. Drag it over this way. Scale it on everything but the Z-axis. How tall is that? Cool. Let's go to another step. Stretch and Z. That looks good. this way a little bit. Yeah. Extrude up just a bit. Select all of these. Extrude and scale. And then shift Z to just make a little flange. So like this. Scale it in. E and down. Cool. You got a little smokestack. That's it. Boop. All right, thanks for watching.